Welcome to today's class. In today's class, we'll discuss about how to interface LCD to 8051 microcontroller. Nowadays, there is a widespread use of LCDs because of few reasons. So, declining prices of LCDs compared to LEDs. The LCDs are cheaper compared to LEDs, and also LCDs have an ability to display the numbers, characters, and also graphics very easily as compared to LEDs. Then also in some of the LEDs there is an inbuilt refreshing controller, so that thereby it relieves the job of CPU to refresh the LCD. That is one of the added advantage when we use LCD. Then programming the characters and graphics will be easy in a case of LCD. Due to these reasons, LCDs are very useful compared to LEDs. So most of the displays in various places like airports, railway stations, bus stations, even in the buses, to display the characters or graphics, we use LCDs. So whenever we interface 8051 microcontroller with the LCD to display any message on the LCD module, so you must know the commands properly. So that is very, very important to write the program either in assembly language or in C language. So these are the certain very important pin descriptions you must know. Especially the pin RS pin, RWO read write pin, and enable pin. So these three pins are very, very important. These are the control pins with respect to the LCD. Remaining eight pins DB0 to DB7. These are the data pins. So that the output of the 8051 microcontroller port that will be connected to the data inputs of LCD display. DB0 to DB7. These are the eight data inputs. So to display any message on the LCD, we need to send the commands first to initialize the LCD, to select a particular position or to turn on the LCD. We need to send commands. So for sending the commands to that, the RS must be 0. RS is equal to 0 to select the command register. While sending the data, RS is equal to 1. That is very, very important. RS is equal to 0 to select the command register. RS is equal to 1. Select the data register, because the same pins are used to send the command and also the data. Then read write operation. So read write is equal to 0 for write operation. To write the data to the LCD, so this pin must be 0. To read the buffer of the LCD, this pin must be 1. Then enable. So only the data available on the data bus or the data present in the data bus will be latched to the LCD only when the enable pin transition from high to low. Whenever the enable pin changes from high to low, so the data present in the LCD data bus that will be latched to the LCD. So these pins are very, very important. Then we see the commands. So these are the various LCD commands. To program the LCD for a particular application, so by using these commands, we can write the program. So all the commands are not required for any particular program. So depending on the requirement, you can use the suitable commands. For example, if you want to clear the display before displaying any new message, so by sending the command 01H to the LCD, it will clear the display. So return to the home position, we need to send the command 02. Similarly, to shift the cursor right or left, these are the command is 5 for right, command is 7 for shift the display left, and again to switch on the display, the commands 0EH or 0FH is used. So display is also on, the cursor is also blinking. So depending on that, whether you want the cursor or not, the suitable command will be used. Then to shift the cursor position, so after displaying a particular character, the cursor will be shifted either to the left or right. So accordingly, we have to choose the commands like 10H or 14H. But in this particular program, we are using the commands. One is 38H to select two lines. Then one more command, 80H, that means it force the cursor to beginning of the first line. So we are using a two line display. So to force the cursor to the first position in the first line, the command is 80H. Suppose if we send the command 81H, then it will move the data to the first line, second position, and so on. Similarly, to start displaying any message in the second line, the command should be C0. So each line we can able to display up to 16 characters. So depending on the position where you want to display the number or the character, so these commands will be changed. So this is for first line, first position. C0 is for second line, first position. Similarly, in the program, we have turned on the both the display and also to blink the cursor, the command 0FH is used. To clear the display screen, the 0 1H is used. These are the commands used in the program, which I am explaining later. Now we move on to the program. So as I already created the program in the Keel Microvision. So here I'll explain the program once again. So here I am taking the two variables temp1 and temp2. So those are assigned with an address of 34H and 35H. So these are the temp1 and temp2H. Before sending any data to LCD or the command or the data, I am storing those values in the temporary variables temp1 and temp2. So temp1 is at an address of 34H. Temp2 is equated with 35H. So that is an address for temp2. So your program starts at origin of 00H. So L call LCD underscore init. So L call means it is a local call. It is a subroutine call. The name of the subroutine is LCD underscore init. Before displaying any message, we have to initialize the LCD. So this is a subroutine used for LCD initialization. But in our lab, we are using the LCD in the 4-bit mode. So to change that from 8-bit mode to 4-bit mode, we are calling LCD underscore init subroutine. So now the program control will go to LCD initialization part. So this is the subroutine for LCD initialization. So the main function of the LCD initialization function is we have to send the LCD command 30H 3 times, then send a command 20H. Command 30H 3 times and send the command 20H 1 time so that your LCD get changed from initialization, get changed from 8-bit mode to 4-bit mode. Because even though the port size is 8 bits, we are using only 4-bit because only the 4 bits are connected internally in the kit which we are using. Therefore, we have to change from 8-bit mode to 4-bit mode. For that, these are the commands used. Send the command 30H 3 times and send the command 20H 1 time. So this is for changing the LCD from 8-bit mode to 4-bit mode. So whenever we send the command, first we have to send 30H to the temp1. So we are moving that 30H to temp1. Now the temp1 contains 30H. Then for writing this value 30H, to write this value to the LCD, again I am calling one more subroutine, L call write command WR underscore CN. That is a command that will write 30H to the LCD. So then the program control will transfer to the subroutine write underscore CN. So this is the program control will go to write underscore CN. So here, whatever the value present in that variable temp2, L call write underscore CN, it will go to write underscore CN. This is the command write underscore CN. So where temp2 will be moved to the accumulator A. Temp2 will be moved to the accumulator. Whatever the value present in the temp2, that will be moved to the accumulator. Then sending the A value to the port 2. Sending the A value to the port 2. Here we are using the port 2 for the LCD. A to port 2. Clear P2.7. While writing the command, the RS pin must be 0. So here, the RS pin of the LCD is connected to pin number 7th pin of port 2. The RS pin of the LCD is connected to port 2 pin number 7. So to make the RS is equal to 0, the instruction is CLR, clear the that particular pin number so that RS becomes 0. Then set bit P2.6, we are enabling the enable pin. So when, as I already explained, when the enable changes from high to low, so then the command will be write to LCD. So we are enabling that set B P2.6. So now it is P2.6, that is enable pin is equal to 1. Then there is some delay. NOP means no operation. So just we are introducing some delay between high to low transition. So immediately it will not happen. So we have to give some delay. So NOP 3 times. No operation. So you will get some delay. These instructions will not perform any operation. Just it takes some time for execution. Thereby introduces a delay between transition from 1 to 0. Then clear P2.6. So the same pin we are clearing to 0. Here we are setting that P2.6. That means enable is equal to 1. Here we are making enable is equal to 0. That means high to low transition. Then writing the command to LCD will be completed. Then RET. It will return to the main program. Okay. So now the initialization is over. So then it will call another subroutine. Similarly, L call clear display. So that means to clear the display, again we have to send 01H. So it will go to clear display command. So we are moving 01H to the accumulator. Then A is moving on to temp 1. A is moving on to temp 1. So now the temp 1 contains 01H. 01H is the command to clear the display. Again I am calling one more command, LCD underscore command. So this is the LCD underscore command. LCD underscore command to write the command. So because 01H means that represents an 8 bit, but only the 4 data pins we are using because we have changed the mode from 8 bit to 4 bit. Therefore, first we have to send only 4 bits, then we have to send the remaining 4 bits. Therefore, we are masking the higher the nibble here. A is equal to 01H. A is equal to 01H. That means lower nibble is 1. The upper nibble is 0. ANL and logical A with 0FH. So here we are masking the lower nibble. We are masking the lower nibble. And then swap. So after swapping, after execution of this instruction, the A contains upper nibble is 0. Upper nibble is 0 and the lower nibble is also 0. So here first we are sending the upper nibble. So the 0 value we are swapping. So the lower nibble is swapped with upper nibble because only the pins 2.0, 2.1, 2.2 and 2.3. These are the pins connected to the output. These are the pins connected to the data pins of LCD, therefore we are swapping that. We are taking the upper 4 bits, we are sending it to P0, 2.0 to P2.3, 4 pins. For that, we are using the swap instructions, or you can use rotate write, RRA, 4 times you can write it. So then, the upper 4 bits will occupy the positions of lower 4 bits. Similarly, here we are masking the upper nibble and we are sending only the lower nibble. So that means 01H. Here we are sending 0, here we are sending 1H. So that it will clear the display. So this is the logic for clearing the LCD. So then move temp 1, 80H. It is a command that will select the first line, first character. Then to write that command, we are calling L call LCD underscore command. Then L call delay. After writing each command, there must be a delay because it takes certain time to complete the write operation to the LCD, to write the data from 8051 microcontroller port pins to LCD data pins. It takes some time. Therefore, there is a delay. L call, L delay. Delay is the name of the subroutine. L delay. So then we are moving the characters SJCIT to